Welcome to the Trans Tasman Clash of the Sidecars right here at Rosebank Speedway. Brilliant day of qualifying here. It's a Friday. Who goes to Speedway on a Friday? We do. We're the lucky ones. 17 bikes, two former New Zealand champions, John Hannon, Russell Stewart, they're here as well to try and qualify for 9 bikes through to Sunday's big event with the internationals when the Aussies will be on the track. It's going to be awesome. Former New Zealand champion John Hannon, long way to travel for you up from Palmerston North. Good to see you here for qualifying.
Yeah, no, long day. But now we're here to give it a good crack. We've got to turn our season around a bit, been a bit lame since Christmas. So, yeah, got the services of Ann Plummer with me. Well experienced, but last time we were together 27 years ago. So.
Wow,
yeah.
Really?
Yep. It swung for me at my first New Zealand title. So, yeah, I thought we'd go a bit faster since then.
Yeah, well, you've won a couple of New Zealand titles since then. Your form at Palmerston North, you've had some good races.
Yeah, we started off with a Histon and a Roar, and as I say, we sort of went off the wall and started changing a few things, and yeah, that was sort of working for us. So I think we're slowly getting back with our setup to where we were. So yeah, a few more meetings, hopefully we'll be knocking on the door again. So
Rosebank here, this is what I call real speedway. Running the speedway style back end on these bikes, to me, speedway is all about getting sideways and full gas, and that's what Rosebank throws up.
Yeah. The thing is, there's a lot of material there though. It looks a bit thin again from like the last time we were here, so yeah, we'll just have a go and see what turns out, I suppose.
They've graded it since the New Zealand Solo GP, which has taken out a couple of the issues that were on track last meeting, and I think with all the water they've thrown down, there might be a bit more top surface there than what you're thinking.
Yeah, hopefully that's the case.
So the goal, try and get through the top 9 today, make that big show on Sunday against the Aussies.
Yep, that's the plan. That'll be a sort of a win in itself, I think, to get through today. So, yeah, as I say, we're just trying to climb back up to where we started the season, basically. So, yeah, that's the aim. So.
Well, good luck for qualifying, and both to you and Ann.
Okay, thanks, guys.
27 bike from Auckland this time. We've got Sean Mason on the back with Dylan Moore riding. Guys, got to make it through that top 9 today so that you can make the big show on Sunday.
Yeah, it should be pretty tight. I've looked at the format and 3 races. We've got to make points in every race, so let's see how we go.
Is this the type of track that you like?
Yeah, it's definitely a track that we kind of favour a little bit more coming from the solos, both of us. But yeah, it's just going to be good, real close racing. Find the bigger tracks, everyone's more spaced out, so these ones kind of make good racing.
Dylan, you have the same sentiments, mate?
Yeah, definitely.
Of course, the Aussie's going to get to ride tomorrow night as well at Western Springs, where there's only a few of the New Zealand guys that are riding. But on Sunday, it's going to be a very tight 16 bike field.
Yeah, no, for sure. Like, we've got quite a lot of local guys here that go well around the track. The Aussie guys do ride some of the tracks, so they'll kind of, you know, be on tune and be up to pace pretty quickly. But just got to wait and see, really, and see how it unfolds.
Hard to say how the track's going to be as well, Dylan. You know, it's had a regrade. There's plenty of water going down. John thought that it might not be enough top surface, but when you have a look out there, I think with the 1,000 cc's generating some track surface today, it might be good.
Yeah, I did, because last meeting there was a bit slick, but hopefully there's a bit of dirt this time.
We love the dirt.
Hey, good luck, guys, and hopefully you can make it through the top 9. We'll be keeping an eye on Kim and Kerry Johnston, the husband and wife crew. You guys travel a lot. It's good to see you up here on a Friday at Rosebank.
Yep. We're Blenheim last weekend. Up here Friday, Saturday, Sunday, back home Monday afternoon.
And in between, you do about a 70-hour work week.
Yep, try to, yeah.
Just shows how enthusiastic you guys are. It's going to be a tough meeting today for qualifying with only 9 bikes making the field.
Yep, that's right.
You know, your season's starting to slowly turn around. You had some issues earlier in the year getting bikes sorted out and everything, but you've started showing some form.
Yep, Mike Zahn built us this new bike, and we're just starting to get used to it every time we hop on it, better and better.
Just at the right time with the North Island Champs on your home track in 3 weeks.
Yep, that's right. Hopefully the track holds up and get a good crew of bikes there, we could.
Well, I definitely want to see a bay bike through for Sunday now that Troy Deverick's not here.
Yeah.
We had 2 chances. You guys are our last hope.
We'll try our best.
Yeah, have a good one.
Thank you, Mike.
Our furthest travelled rider, the 95i, Irwin Tree and Brett Pubbin here. Good to have you guys all the way from Invercargill, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Big effort.
Oh, she was a bit of an effort coming up. I will admit that one. The old road between the Lewis Pass and Picton, she was a bit dicey with that weather bomb.
You've only done done about six meetings so far this season, but how have they been working out?
We're going alright, having a lot of fun. Basically just playing with the bikes. Brett's first season back, had a few years off. Basically we're just having a bit of fun, getting experience under our belts and working towards Moore Park in a couple of years' time.
Coming here to Rosebank, you like this?
Yep. No, last time I was up here riding was five, six years ago.
Right, so a reasonable time ago.
Yeah, so now we've come up, fun, and see what this old girl's going to do on the track.
Were you running the Speedway back in then?
Yep. No, we're on a different bike back then.
Yep.
We're on Murhan bike back then. Now we've got a Stinger, built by Mike's aunt Napier. Bought off Glen Murray this time last year. So still coming to grips with it.
17 good bikes here today. 8 are going to miss out. 9 go through for qualifying for Sunday. You're going to make sure you're one of those 9.
Yeah, we'll give it a nudge. You know, we're here, that's what I said, we're here to have the experience, give it a go and just take it as it comes.
Yeah, you want to be in the main show, you don't want to be in support on that Sunday.
Oh, of course you want to be in the main show, but if it doesn't go that way, it doesn't go that way.
Plus, you get to watch Western Springs tomorrow night and get a bit of a gauge on the Australian riders.
Yep, that's going to be the good one, is here to go and watch them there. And I was up helping with Canterbury for Jamie Moon on New Year's Day and that, at Western Springs, and yeah, it was a bit of an eye-opener. Cleanways from Cargill, Osborne Engineering and Bluff, Dunbar Generating, Topline Speedway Supplies, Southern Ocean Safety and Bluff.
Proud Kiwi.
Oh, proud Kiwi. Thanks, Jamie. Brett for putting up with me on the trip up. K&D Automotive, they done a full service and check on the van before we come to make sure she was all road legal. Wilbur Ellis, Bluff, well, Bluff and Cargill. And Jamie and Sam for letting us stay last night. And yeah.
For a guy that was trying to hide behind the van and not talk to us, we're having trouble making him stop now. Hey, we want to see at least one mainlander in the final on Sunday, so good luck, mate.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Dave Adam and Andy Duff on the 83.